We have seen that we can if convert if then else's. A similar technique would be very useful for a loop, but can we really if convert a loop? Let's go back to our loop that loads from some memory address, adds something to that, stores that back in memory, adds 4 to the pointer, to the beginning of the loop, unless the pointer has reached some final value. Let's say that in this processor, every operation takes 2 cycles to do, so we will have a stall cycle here, because we need to use R2 2 cycles later. Another stall cycle here, because the add needs to operate for 1 more cycle before the store can see that value. There is no stall cycle here, because this add can actually proceed immediately, it doesn't depend on the store. And then the branch gets delayed by 1 more cycle, because it's using the result of the add. So we have 3 stall cycles here, and again, this is a processor where every operation just takes 2 cycles. We have already seen that we can schedule this loop differently, so that we load, and then we do the add I, and then we do the add. This way we avoid the stall cycle here. However, after this add, the only things that are left to do in this iteration of the loop are the store and the branch. We cannot do the branch before the store, so the store has to happen here. And thus, we haven't eliminated this stall cycle here. And then the branch can check R1 for whether it reached the final value here, because without a stall, because R1 has been manipulated here. And then we had to change this store, if you remember, because the add of a constant has moved here, so that it uses a -4 offset to compensate for this. So we managed to eliminate 2 of these stall cycles, but 1 still remains. Now, if you look at this branch here, if conversion would allow us to kind of do the next iteration of the loop here and then eliminate this branch because it would be predicated, and then we could maybe find something here that can go over here. But the problem is that a loop is not really suitable for if conversion, because every time we have a new iteration, we would have to introduce a new predicate, and then every new iteration would introduce yet another predicate, and we simply cannot deal with so many predicates and so many things that get done only if the predicate is true. Pretty much if we are executing a 1,000,000 iteration loop, sometimes, and sometimes only 1 iteration, then almost 1,000,000 iterations would have to be just predicated out, which would be very, very slow. So we want to do something about loops that is like if conversion to allow us to kind of find things in future iterations to move here, but without really doing if conversion. So we cannot truly if convert, but there is something else we can do. And that something will be called loop unrolling.